Hello everyone and welcome back. In this tutorial, we will learn how we can use the zoom feature in Microsoft PowerPoint available under the Insert tab. The zoom feature can also be used in several other ways, but in this video, we will use it to create a zoom in animation loop. The animation is inspired by Dennis Hugstad's new home at dribble.com. Creating an exact replication of this animation in PowerPoint was a bit difficult, but we still tried our best. We have created two different versions of this animation in PowerPoint. In this first presentation, we are using the zoom feature, and in the second presentation, we are only using the PowerPoint animation effects. You can download both the presentations for free from our Patreon page, and you can encourage us to do much better work by supporting us at Patreon. Let's first talk about the zoom feature, and this presentation contains a total of 3 slides. Open the selection pane from the Home tab and animation pane from the Animations tab, so we may see the names of all the objects and the animation effects applied to them. The second object on the slide is the subtracted face, which is larger than the slide size, and we have applied the basic zoom effect to it. Double-click the effect in animation pane to open the effect options properties window. The zoom style is set to in, and if you want, then you can also use zoom in from screen center or zoom in slightly. We used the merge shapes subtract command over a rectangle shape by drawing a face on it using the freeform shape tool. The next object on the slide is the sun, and it has been grouped with a larger oval, which has been made hidden using the no fill and no outline color. We used the spin effect with a 35 degree clockwise rotation. So when these grouped ovals rotate, the sun comes behind the subtracted rectangle. You can note down the time duration and delay timings from the timing section of the Animations tab. Over water, ground, tree, house, and ship, we have applied the fly in entrance effect. Only the ship is coming from the right side, and the rest are flying in from the bottom. We also applied the appear effect to all these objects with a delay timing of 1 second, as we don't want them to appear while the subtracted rectangle is zooming in. If we zoom into the house and look over the window, then you can see that it is not a window but a smaller size of the entire slide, and that is where we are using the zoom feature of PowerPoint. First, we created a duplicate of the first slide, and then from the Insert tab, we used Slide Zoom from the Zoom drop-down menu. We then linked that with the second slide. We resized the zoom and placed it as a window in the house. We also applied the basic zoom effect with a delay timing of 2.50 seconds. So, when you see the slideshow and click over the zoom window, then it replicates the same animation effects from the second slide. On the second slide, we just changed the delay timings of the effect, as we want them to start appearing after the zoom transition ends. You can configure the zoom transition timings from the Zoom tab. As we have 3 duplicated slides linked together through Zoom, if you continue to click on the Zoom window during the slideshow, then you will see all the effects getting played only 3 times, and after that only the Zoom transition will appear without the animation effects. So, you can create more duplicate slides if you want the animation effects to get played continuously if someone clicks on the window. The good thing about the Zoom feature is that it automatically zooms out all the objects when someone clicked on the Zoom window. That is the first time I am using this zoom feature, and will try to explore more ideas to use this feature in our upcoming tutorials. The first slide in the second presentation is identical to the first presentation, but we are not using the zoom feature in it. Instead, we are applying the animation effects on the second slide to make all the objects disappear. We are using the basic zoom exit effect over the subtracted rectangle and then grow shrink with motion path to move all the objects out of the slide area during the slideshow. The third slide is a duplicate of the first slide and the fourth slide is a duplicate of the second slide. We also configure the advanced slide transition timings according to the duration of all the animation effects on that slide. So when you play the slideshow, then it repeats the animation 2 times without any user interaction, and if you want to create a longer loop, then you can create more duplicate slides. I hope you will like the idea and the tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing, and commenting on the video. Subscribe to our channel and press the notification bell for the upcoming tutorials. Thanks a lot for watching and do take good care of yourself.